Let's pray. God of all wisdom, the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be pleasing to you, our rock and our redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
So a minister told his congregation, next week I'm planning to preach about sin of lying. So to help you understand better, I want all of you to read Mark chapter 17. The following Sunday, he prepared to deliver his sermon, and minister asked, show of hands, who have read the Mark 17? Some raised immediately, while others kind of looked around and hesitantly just kind of followed along and raised hands. And so the majority of the congregation member had their hands raised. The minister smiled and said, Mark has only 16 chapters, and I will now proceed with my sermon on the sin of lying. I think we are all guilty of lying, right? Some possibly were big lies, while most probably were of those little white lies, which might have been harmless and not so much a big deal. What is a lie? So I'm going to actually give you a dictionary definition. Lie is a false statement made with a deliberate intent to deceive, an intentional untruth. But lie is also intentionally denying truth. Telling a lie is usually something that we picture as doing to others. But what I would like to address today are the lies that we applicate into our own lives, because these lies takes us into darkness caused by reasons such as animosity, conflict, discontent, and denial. First John was written to the church, the congregations that were becoming unglued. Gnostics had the Christian community to question everything about their faith. And this uncertainty created conflicts among the community. So instead of seeking the truth and be grounded in a core of their faith in Jesus, that Jesus as the Son of God, who became flesh and lived among his people, teaching, loving, and serving until he was betrayed and died and resurrected from the cross as a savior, this was all being questioned. What's worse is that the one who decided to leave the community tried to divide the communities further so they can recruit them onto their side. So there were conflicts within these early churches all throughout Asia Minor at the time. John mentioned his reason for this letter, the first John, was in chapter 5, and it states, I write these things to you who believe in the name of the Son of God, so that you may know that you have eternal life. This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. The ones who were once a member of a Christian community declaring their faith took action that went against their faith. Instead of using positive, upward spiral words to build each other up, they criticize with judgment, discontent, and anger. Instead of showing grace in order to divide the community, they promoted shadows in their hearts, lying to themselves by disguising the darkness with self-righteousness, losing their integrity. Initially, they winced in the beginning, knowing that things were not true, that they were wrong. But these actions eventually were justified through lies they tell themselves and others that it was really okay. Eventually, they convinced themselves that the actions causing darkness was right all along. I think we can relate that this is also happening in current worlds. This is a contradiction between what we declare with the mouths of all the things we live in Jesus, but live in ways that destroy the very relationship. This is a lie. needs to be acknowledged through confession. Only through confession can we begin a step toward reconciliation. If we have a physical or mental illness, we have to admit that we are ill in order for us to seek healing. For all the addicts, first step towards being sober or clean is to admit that they have addictions. Same goes for our shortcomings. For example, first I put it, but I'm going to use when. When I get very overwhelmed, I know that you will be there to help as long as I admit it, as long as I come to you. But I also know the dangers of it. If I stay true and say, no, I don't want them to see anything, I don't just want all of you guys to think I'm perfect, it's a downward spiral for me, I know. Thank goodness at age 50, I was able to realize that. If we choose to hide our illness, our struggles, our shortcomings, and our frustrations, we end up stepping away from God's grace, falling deeper into darkness. There are many obvious darknesses that we witness nowadays through social media and many other internet sites. Some are blatant intention to cause pain, while others cause darkness in an attempt to fight for the light. For example, last week there was a video that went viral where a white older female began mocking an elderly Mexican woman simply doing her yard work. Her son approached this unknown white woman, and this woman revealed her racism by calling this college-educated Mexican immigrant of being a drug dealer and a rapist. Many, including this white woman, justify this by stating our president as the source of our righteousness, source of their righteousness. I have to tell you that no matter how powerful a person may be, our own individual behaviors cannot be justified by another human's behavior. This woman's behavior cannot be blamed on anyone else but herself, just like we are responsible for our own behaviors. We are accountable to God on how we decide to live. Is it in the darkness or is it in the light? Is it in darkness or is it in light? Are we going to hide the light by promoting darkness, or strive to live the way Jesus taught us to live so we can spread the light? It's our choice. God gave us that choice. As we all know, racism is a plague. It spreads darkness, tapping into the spaces in our hearts where there might be void, maybe scars of pain, fear, and prejudice that cause hatred and violence in words and action. Racism is darkness and shadows over love, kindness, and shadows over the acceptance that Jesus exemplified in our world. The only way to defeat racism is for every individual to be true to Jesus' teachings and be true to our faith by living the life Jesus led us to live, so that we can be the light that casts out the darkness. Years ago, when my oldest daughter, Anna, was 15, she signed up for a driver's ed class. This was a huge class, and I talked to so many moms whose child went through, and they couldn't talk nothing but positive things. One day, I believe it was about after second or third class, she got in the car completely disturbed. I asked her what was going on, and she said that day, the instructor asked one African-American student, one Jewish student, and my daughter as the Asian to stand up. They stood up, and he went to one each. told some joke about Black and Decker to an African-American student. And then told some story, a joke, according to him, about how a friend of his got robbed and they know that it was Asian because the dog was missing. Stereotyping of Asians eating dogs. As you understand, when something happens to your own child, doesn't matter who you are, right? The anger within me was just brewing. I tried to call this person to confront, and the office would not answer the phone. I left him messages. I wrote him letters, and I sent copies to the school boards and all the anybody that who I thought should know. Later on, about a week later, I got a response back from him, and he said this was his way of trying to relate to the students closer. There was no apology. There was no admittance of wrongdoing. In fact, he justified it, saying this was a joke. I was angry. I was so angry that I even consulted with a friend who was a lawyer, ready to sue him. But at the end, I had to forgive him, because only change that could happen is for him to do within himself. I cannot change him. That was not within me. But that forgiveness was very difficult. Very difficult. But I knew that if I didn't, that anger within me was going to spread to somewhere else. So I prayed earnestly and forgave him, hoping that his ignorance will somehow be better, acknowledged. Hate is darkness. Racism is darkness. Judgment is darkness. Rudeness is darkness. Exclusion is darkness. Self-boasting and gossip cause darkness. We can easily be the darkness, the very darkness we want to rebuke. Every time we promote hate, rudeness, criticize, judge, we bring in darkness. Each time we deny reconciliation, we create darkness. Each time we turn away from each other because of a conflict, we create darkness. Each time we decide to judge instead of showing grace, we bring darkness into our community. Each time we decide to rebuke instead of embracing each other, we cause darkness. However, the good news is that the light is within us. The Holy Spirit within us is the light placed in us through Jesus Christ to shine upon others by offering kindness, acceptance, praise, compliments, and even simple greetings. God doesn't expect us to like everything and everyone. Remember, God's love, agape, is not based on our feelings, but it's based on our choice. Our choice is to be faithful servants to practice God's love with each other, to extend this love to everyone that we come across. So if there's conflict, we need to confront with agape. If we are troubled, we need to address it with agape. If we are unhappy, offended, or hurt, we need to be healed through agape. I'm sure you'll agree with me that this is so much easier said than done. How does God expect us to do this when too often we are driven by our feelings? Well, in today's letter, John tells us, if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he who is faithful and just will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin, but here is the good news. If anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins. And not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. We are all sinners. And the reason we are gathered here to worship God is because we accept each other as sinners, desiring to be reconciled. We are here with the understanding that God's grace is among us. And we are called to share this gift of grace with each other. But doesn't seem that being in the darkness seems easier than being in the light? Hate seems easier than love? People believe one can hide in the darkness, forgetting that no one can hide from God. Light seems to expose us to all aspects of our being, especially our vulnerability. But what we forget is that light includes love of God. Love so strong that God came into human form to meet us where we are so that we can have better understanding of God's love. And through Jesus Christ, we can have deeper understanding of that very love and the light that is God's love embracing each one of us. John declared in his first letter that when he saw Jesus, "Here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world." Through Jesus Christ, we all can choose to be reconciled. From a daily devotional called Today in the World, a famed psychiatrist named Carl Menninger once said that if he could convince patients in psychiatric hospitals that their sins were forgiven, 75% of them could walk out that next day. The love and peace that we receive through reconciliation shines a light within us, and we are to shine our light unto others by offering God's love and grace. Finally, I want to share with you a prayer founded in a clothing of a dead child at Ravensbrück concentration camp. The prayer goes like this. O Lord, remember not only the men and women of goodwill, but also those of ill will. But do not remember all the suffering they have inflicted upon us. Instead, remember the fruits we have borne because of this suffering, our fellowship, our loyalty to one another, our humility, our courage, our generosity, the greatness of heart that has grown from this trouble. When our persecutors come to be judged by you, let all these fruits that we have borne be their forgiveness. We were not born into darkness. We are born to be the light of God through Jesus Christ. Let us all strive to live in this light. Amen. Amen.